Nice. Only 5 experience points? Huh. That's lame. Speaking of lame, well, she's not lame, she went insane. Let's get the heck out of here. We don't have a return point for that one. Oh, more insects! I'm not sure how much more of this we can take. We're walking away from the mine, though. Well, we gotta heal her. Hopefully there's someone in town who knows how to do that. We've learned that they are vulnerable to fireball. Well, she went insane, so she's moving up. Keep up the fireballs. Good work. Hopefully we don't get attacked too many more times by these. Ouch. I think we did. So we know that make sure nothing is broken. I don't see anything broken, let me just check. Can't check her. I'm gonna do my little save state. I'm gonna try to move over in case we can't get rid of it quickly enough. So these things come out at night then? Or just near the mine? We need to heal him. I don't need all healing. Valdyn could use a little healing too, but eh. Oh, youth potion. I don't even remember picking that up. Cure poison. We need healing potions. This is no good. We don't have healing potions? Oh boy. He gets damaged too much more. We're gonna have to back him off. We do still have 137. These hit for like 50 something. And are they hitting twice around, I think? And attacks for 13. Yeah, twice around. Boom. Only 6? I still got it. Get me out of here. Hello, did we talk to you before? You speak to an old dwarf lady. She says, "Visit our crystal garden, travelers, and see what beauty we have given up forever through our naive hopes." Okay. That's one hell of a way to put it. We need a rest. Is this the inn? I think it is. Yeah. Yeah, we got hit hard there. It's not gonna heal her madness, but 241 points regained. I want to see... Okay. So that cures poison. Wait. What do we have here? Calmir? I don't think that's on there. Oh, it is, but it says... Oh, no, it isn't. It's not on here. So I don't know what that does. Maybe it heals madness. We used to have something that healed madness in the Amber Star. I guess one 59 now, right? I don't want to waste it. I mean, you can explain it away as in-universe, we should know what this stuff does. It didn't help her. I'm gonna leave it as is. We have a bunch of them. So we need to find somewhere around here that is not the hot tub room. We need to find somewhere that we can heal her status. Her madness. We don't get attacked by any more wasps. We'll stay away from the mine for the time being. Oh god! These things always attack? And this is no good. We don't have our healer. At least we got everything back. I mean, our healer is the one who can cure madness, but she's the one that has madness. Cause madness. It's not gonna help us. Fireball. Oh, it's causing madness on someone else and lame. Oh, I guess it happened to Nelvin? Or did he cast that? He's fine. I guess he cast that spell. I missed it. Anyone else affected? Oh, he's been turned lame. But they're gonna gradually wear us down. Unless this heals lameness. Or maybe this does. Hold on. That's... yeah, these are potions. These are Ambermoon potions. Yeah, I don't have something that tells us what these potions do. And I don't want to waste time experimenting. So he cannot attack. The irritate spell. Doesn't seem right that these things just attack in town. I mean, we weren't having a problem. Until we went by the mine, I guess we woke those things up? Maybe? Well, we're just lucky the first time we weren't running into them. Alright, we got rid of one. Oh, that's Valdyn. They give no XP, these things. It's not a happy situation with these things around, that's for sure. Hopefully someone can cure our status before we die. That thing. Okay. So ahead is something. Is that not a door? It sure looks like a door, doesn't it? Wait. Alright, doesn't seem to be anything. It's a door we can't go through. Maybe we can get through this way. No? It's like it doesn't even exist. So what is this place? It's like the doors don't exist, like they're just really painted on the walls. They're painted doors. There's no way in there. What about north from here? Anything besides wasps? I can't talk to you if you, like, back off like that. This is one of Dor Kiridan's guards who constantly patrols the streets. He welcomes you and says only, "Beware of the wild beasts of nature." Yeah, no kidding. Now you tell me. They warned me about outside, but I didn't figure there'd be anything inside. Alright. So I wonder what this place is here. And that's the mine. East. Oops. Alright. Dead end here. Man, if we have nothing to cure these status effects, we're doomed. Doomed, I tell ya! Doomed! That's the side entrance for Kiri's dwelling. Headed towards the tavern again, right? We're headed this way. Oh, towards this building, so we can see what this is. There's gonna be another place we can't actually get into. Oh, that's the other side of it. Okay, let's head south. This is a structure. Thank you. Tell me you're a healer. Ferrin's workshop, weapons and tools. We don't need that. Ferrin Smithy. Let me guess, you're Ferrin? Welcome. If you have anything needing repair, we shall be pleased to do it for you. Come to the counter. You're going to have to be over here. Yeah, we need our Sabine and our Valdyn repaired. I hope there's someone here can help us. The many tools in the belt of the person opposite you tell you he must be the blacksmith's assistant. He stops working to say, Ferrin, my master, it is one of the great... Well, Ferrin, my master, is one of the greatest blacksmiths our people have ever had. Only he, of all the master blacksmiths, managed to extend his artistic skills to the wood found on this world. Today, we produce truly wonderful weapons and tools, most of them of refined hardwood. Look at the assortment on the counter. Normally, Ferrin would also show you around with pride, but his family is in mourning. Alright, I guess that's Ferrin. Get to ask why he's in mourning. Oh. He went through us. We're ghosts. You get into conversation with a dwarf dressed in green. He says, there's a depressed atmosphere in Ferrin's house these days. I believe something happened to his little daughter. You know that we dwarfs are not often blessed with children, so the loss is indescribable. Well, where's Ferrin? Is this Ferrin? You see a powerful dwarf absent-mindedly playing with a hammer, which weighs at least 20 kilograms. The expression in his face tells you nothing. Well, he's holding it in. Here's Ferrin. 220-year-old dwarf. Level 9 adventurer. Welcome, adventurers. I would prefer to be left alone with my sadness at the moment. Ask about mourning. Ferrin looks at you blackly and finally takes a deep breath and continues. Well, okay. I should not miss an opportunity. Perhaps you can find out what has happened. 4 days ago, my little daughter disappeared from the storage cellar at my own home. She was supposed to fetch something, as so often. She never returned. Simply disappeared without a trace. All our searching was in vain. We found tracks left by feet with claws, but none of the damn beasts were to be seen. We don't know what happened, and hope is dying day by day. He closes his eyes and just whispers, I sent her down there myself. He hands you a key without saying another word. Is that the key of the mine? Ferrin's key. Give it to Celine. He's our key master. Please, help, or keep silent. Daughter? Really? Brog. Dorgreston. Dorkiridon. Dorina. Your journey. The inn. Here. Magic. Magic words. I ask everyone about the magic words. Problem. Problems. Oh, storage cellar? Okay. I'm gonna just ask him about this other stuff. Thomas Fugit. Trouble. What do you say? What about Chon? Tornak. Storage cellar. The cellar was built during a test digging, but the mine was never finished, and so I used the rooms for storage. You can go through the cellar. Take the steps behind the door in the west part of the house. Please, try to find something. Even the worst news is better than this uncertainty. Well, if we can turn our fighters, and well, our fighter and our healer, to fighting status, we'll definitely do so. Farewell. Gonna look around a little bit. Sounds like the cellar's in one of the other rooms here. So, we'll go see. One of Ferrin's tools. Same. Is it full of beer? Wait. Wood. Hello? I got a red-haired dwarf. This is Ferrin's wife. Her eyes are red and tearful. She shakes her head when she speaks. But she doesn't actually say anything. Wait. Let's see if she would actually say anything. No, okay. Hello? The dwarf standing before you is incredibly old. He speaks with a trembling voice. And they told me I should calm down. It is nothing, they said. I felt it every night down there, how they searched all around. But I'm very old. Old and worn out. His voice became lost in an incomprehensible mumble. Alright, so one of these rooms has a cellar. We're not going down in it yet. Unless somebody in this place can cure our status effects here. Is that the way? The lock on this door is made of wood, but is nevertheless of exceptional quality. Well, that must be the way down. We're not going there in this condition. These always look like stairs, like steps down to me. It's that old style RPG steps. You like sometimes see in JRPGs. Like the older ones, of course. So that's him, right? Oh, is it? Oh, that's Ferrin. So who's this? So we talk to him? The salesman considers Ferrin's assortment. Tools and weapons made out of wood, better than most people make out of metal. Come to the counter and I will show you what we have. We need healing. Welcome, you have come just in time to profit from my incredible bargains. That sounds familiar. Ooh, a swift stabber. Sounds interesting. A sling dagger. Huh. Can you use that with slings? A sling knife. Damage plus 18? It's ammunition. Huh. That's cool. plus 18. This one's ammunition plus 28. A swift stabber. Only usable by adventurer, which is me, warrior, which is Edgel, paladin, which you do not have, Selena, thief, and ranger, Valdyn. Close range weapon. Plus 32. It's pretty good. Pretty good. Actually, it's better than what any of us have. I have a dwarf axe, too. Well, we gotta come back here. Let me go investigate the cellar. That's for sure. Profit from his incredible bargains. Oh, that's a repair guy. Not the way out. At the Smithy Tavern, Curious Dwelling. Explore the rest. If we don't get attacked. Nothing back here. This way. Oh, what do we find? Oh, the city gates. Is this really? I guess that's really where we came in. Alright. And this is another. Okay. Places that don't exist. I mean, these doors that don't. It's just a window. Wow. Teasing me. A citizen of Dor Kiridan speaks to you. Do not leave the town without being well armed. Ferrin in the southeast of Dor Kiridan is a master in the manufacture of clever weapons. That's not what we need. We need a healer sage type. Doesn't appear that they have any. Well, that's one hell of a problem. We haven't seen what's around that corner. Assuming nothing, really. follow the place around here. Oh, supposed to head east. There is not much here. We're really out of luck, aren't we? Let's see if one of these things cures the lameness. Seem to have done so. Wrong place to use the item. What else do we have? Remove curses. This is an all-healing potion. Oh, that got rid of that. Swamp Lily doesn't get rid of that either. Wonder what the bitter does. You have to be asleep to use it. Hold on a second. I'm experimenting. So you probably need to use it in the camp menu. Place, even in the camp menu. You can only use it outside. Alright, so what we're gonna do, I'm gonna load this save. Oh god, I just loaded a save. How do I get to... Yeah, let's not have that happen right now. So she has... all healing. I'm going to use that on Sabine. And then Sabine is fine. And Sabine will remove lameness. Thus helping him. Well, you know what's funny about these people? They don't seem to, They don't seem to have hours, like they're always open. So let's go to the smithy. Think about if we want to buy some of his wares here. We could trade in Edgel's stuff. I think we'll do that and then go down into the cellar with the key he gave us. See if we can find his daughter down there. Hopefully those things won't have status effects. What I'm going to have to do. I can't waste too many more of those potions. So what I'm probably going to end up doing is if they affect Sabine, I'll have to reload. Unless it's something that this can solve. Because we have plenty of that. Calmir herb. There's no one here in town who's selling potions or herbs that can take care of that, or has a sage who can restore people. Maybe bitter can only be used in a dungeon or out in camp, or it can't be used on the moon. It could be like the earthquake and those kind of spells can't be used on the moon. Wrong world. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.